get ready. Start. Sir, before the house adjourned for lunch yesterday, I had started speaking on the Essential Commodities Amendment Bill. I have got here with me the bill as introduced. In the statement of objects and reasons, the government pointed out that in certain cases it might be necessary for them not to award punishment prescribed in the law as it exists at present, but to forfeit a part of the deposit. This relates to minor offenses under the Essential Commodities Act. I can quite understand this, and generally, therefore, nobody would oppose this thing. But the question that I wish to raise in this connection before the House is the manner in which this act is being implemented by the government and also by the state governments. I mention the state governments because here is a measure which is sponsored by the Ministry of Food and Agriculture, and in regard to many aspects of which I believe the central government has concurrent jurisdiction, but much is left to the states. Our experience has been, especially in the state from which I come, namely West Bengal, that this act is not implemented properly by the state authorities because of various connections of certain people high up with the big business and others indulging in speculation, hoarding, and so on. The result has been that whatever should be done had not been done. The central government has got powers under this act to make rules, to give the directions to the states, and to supervise the manner in which the particular measure is administered by the states. We found that much that should have been done was not done. What is the use of talking about punishment of the small fry? Certainly, if they are guilty, they have to be punished. And the smaller the fry, the minor should be the punishment. I agree there, but the point is that the act is not properly implemented. We should like to know from the government as to how many cases have been started under the Essential Commodities Act. We know that food grains had been hoarded, speculation had been indulged in, stocks had been removed from one state to another surreptitiously by unfair and illegal methods. These should have attracted the attention of the Essential Commodities Act. The Act was passed in this Parliament with a view to putting a check on speculative rise in prices. When it came to the question of practical implementation of this measure, we found that the government had failed. Now, government should say something about it. When government seeks to amend an act, it should tell us as to how the parent act, which is proposed to be amended, has been implemented. Is it the contention of the government that difficulty arises because this particular provision is not there in the act? Are government in trouble because they do not know how to deal with the smaller fries? Or is it because that those who are supposed to administer this measure at the state level, at the district level, have thought it fit to ignore it, have thought it fit to bypass it? If any measure of the central government's was indeed needed for controlling the price of food grains and ensuring the supply of essential commodities to the community, it is the Essential Commodities Act. I would like to minister to say something on this. I know that he was not here at the time when we passed this measure, nor was he there when the Essential Commodities Act was bypassed by many state governments. In the past, we had drawn the attention of the minister to this problem, and that minister is now happily going to be the president of the Uttar Pradesh Congress Committee. But here I would like to ask the minister, who has stepped into his shoes, as to what he is doing in order to see to the power implementation of this act. How many prosecutions have taken place? The small people, of course, should be dealt with very mildly. I agree and I support the measure, but taking the law as it is today, without this amendment, it empowers government to deal very effectively. So far as the provisions of the law go, with the big traders, wholesalers and profiteers, I would like to know as to how they have dealt with them. How many are in jail today? How many have paid fine? How many have suffered imprisonment? How many licenses have been cancelled as a result of malpractices, corruption, profiteering and so on, all of which are provided for under this bill? We are entitled to know. Take us into your confidence in regard to this matter. I say, from whatever knowledge we have, that very few have been prosecuted under this act. If it is so, it is not because our black market trade has suddenly become white market trade, or those impious people have suddenly become virtuous with the succession in the house office of the food minister by a new man.